Hmm? Dada, I don't know if I have the best idea to paint this wall mural. I might need more inspiration. I've always wanted to do one, and now that Mother has asked me to, I just don't know. Dada?
Maddie, you have to see! Something crazy's happened to me! There's a strange creature with a funny face hiding now inside our place!
I'd love to see, but I'm about to start painting my wall. What if I do and it doesn't look right? Oh, and there's gonna be a window right in the top of it.
I think it's magic, that creature inside. I think it wants to take us on a ride!
Ride? What kind of ride? Why are you talking in rhymes?
The creature makes me talk in rhyme all the time. She does really funny stuff, but I think I've had quite enough.
That's crazy. Who's doing that?
Huh? I'm not sure why we are here, but I bet that tricky creature's near.
This place is, wow, nice. But, Dada, you didn't tell me why you're talking in rhymes.
Well, when we were back home, I was trying to write a poem. I was feeling a little tired and wished I was more inspired. And then the funny-faced creature appeared, and now I'm talking really weird.
That sounds crazy and interesting. But I have to get home to start painting the wall.
Painting the wall? I'm just finishing painting my wall, my fresco. Which wall will you be painting?
Not here. I'm going to be painting on the back of our house in the backyard for my mother.
Please permit me to introduce myself. I'm Raphael. It is a great pleasure to meet another artista.
I'm Maddie, and this is Dada.
Dada would be lots of fun, but right now I really have to run. Holy, where did it go? It sure isn't slow.
Your friend Dada, he talks in a rhyme. He is a poet?
Not usually. It's just today is kind of strange.
Yes, today is crazy. But come and see. My fresco is all about the poets and creative inspiration.
I really need some creative inspiration right now. I'm trying to think of ideas for my mural.
Did you say poets and creative inspiration? Since I'm a poet, it's worth my contemplation. I'm sure talking weird ever since that creature appeared.
Yes, this is for you, Mr. Poet. My fresco celebrates poetry through painting.
It's amazing! Like 50 paintings all in one!
The fresco is of Mount Parnassus, the mountain sacred to Apollo, and where the nine muses live. In the middle is Apollo, the god of the poets, son of the god Zeus. And the musical instrument is a lira da braccio. And around him are the nine muses. They are protectors of the arts, responsible for giving creative inspiration.
Raphael, I think you forgot to paint one.
Mia, Mia, she is gone again. I thought my eyes were going funny. She is there, and then she is gone. She's making me crazy. Come, Matty. You must help me paint her again. Everyone is coming tomorrow to see the fresco.
Me? But I don't think I'm good enough for that.
Oh, look. Here is the study of the Mustalia. I have many of them here somewhere. I used these to assist in making the final image. See what I mean? I even studied costume and musical instruments of the time for all the figures in the fresco. Apollo has the lira da braccio, an instrument of his time. And even with the characters in the painting, I also want to express who they are. You see, there is Homer, the poet who wrote great epic poems about adventures of men heroes.
He's blind, but it looks like he's walking forward. Like he's leading the way.
Yes, he is the first important poet, and he leads the way. And he is close to Apollo. And beside him is Dante, who is said to be il sommo poeta, the supreme poet. So I want him beside Homer, and so on.
So you have a picture of the whole fresco before you even start on the wall.
And then I trace it onto the wall. And on this wall, it is a special problem to look. I have that window as an obstruction.
There's also a window in the way of where I want to paint.
Problems are good. Look, it shapes the whole fresco. Because the window is there, it is perfect for my subject of a Mount Parnassus. And see, geometrically, we start with the poet Sappho on the left, and we go up to Apollo and then down to the bottom. Everyone together and the mountain are in the shape of a triangle, perfectly balanced.
With Apollo at the top with the muses around him, they all seem more important than everyone else.
All of these things add to the balance and harmony of a picture.
Oh, where she goes, nobody knows.
Does Dada always play with this funny creature?
No. He said he was trying to write poetry when she started playing tricks on him.
So Dada isn't really a poet. Not all the time.
Dada is more of a comedian than a poet.
I just wanted to see if I didn't chase her, if she would then follow me.
That must be Talia. She's Dada's muse.
So she's the muse of comedy.
It is like with the poets. Inspiration touches us all. See how in the fresco Apollo and the muses are on the top and all the poets come down?
So their inspiration reaches us through those who came before?
Yes, it is passed along. Like with this magnetic stone. It not only attracts iron rings. The way poets and artists are attracted to Apollo and the muses, the iron rings also do the same thing to other rings.
Which is why I love seeing art and hearing music and poetry. It's all so inspiring.
I think she likes Dada because she also likes a comedy. And I think only Dada can bring her back to the fresco.
I hear what you say, and I will try it your way. Talia, Talia, I'm sorry it must be so, but into the painting you must go, go, go. But you must visit another time and teach me more funny rhymes.
Thanks for the awesome inspiration, Raphael. We'll visit again.
Oh, no, I must thank you. Arrivederci.
Look, Dada, I did my studies, and then even shaped it all as an upside-down triangle. And this is the end result. Voila! Do you think my mom will like it?
Like it? She'll love it! And did I tell you? We seem to be stuck with that little rain cloud. So, I found this new way to get it to water all of the plants back here.
I still haven't gotten any ideas what to paint. We should go for a walk and find something fun and exciting and different to paint. Look! If we focus on the line between the shadow and the light, we can see the sun moving.
Da-da, wow!
At that moment, all the swan feathers disappeared. The six brothers turned back into children and happily hugged.